When I go to the doctor's office, everybody had their head down. Everybody knows me, and I'm like, what's going on here? And Dr. Carney, he just looked at me and says, Eric, I don't know how to tell you this, but you have throat cancer. I found out in August, around August 24, 2009. I was just horsing. I went to see my ENT doctor. And the last thing you want to hear is when a specialist puts a strobe down your throat and go, uh-oh. So I said, uh-oh. And he says, yeah, I see your abnormal growth, and I don't like the way it looks. This was on a Thursday. And he said, I want to schedule you for surgery on Monday.
When I was bleeding, I went to the doctor. They did biopsy. They did testing, you know, so on and so forth. Then I thought I was going to die when they told me I had cancer.
I found out I had cancer 3.5 years ago. I was actually going to try to have a baby, and they told me I had uterine cancer. So I'm in remission right now for 3.5 years.
You hear that word cancer, you get afraid initially, right? Such an ugly word. But I'm a man of faith. So immediately faith kicked in, and I remember looking at my wife, and her eyes were watery and glassy, and I looked at my wife. I couldn't say anything, but I moved my lips and I said, God is able.
Since I had no kids, they told me I could try to have a kid, but it didn't work out like that. And I asked them, I need to know the best doctor that takes care of my situation, and they told me about Dr. Soror in Richmond University. He took care of my surgery when I had a hysterectomy, and then I had to go through radiation and chemo.
It changes in a lot of ways. It makes you feel thank God that you don't have it anymore, but then you worry that you may get it again. Because I was told it's going to come back. Thank God, 6 years, and I still worry that if it comes back.
After several treatments of radiation, she's been checking me out, and I'm in remission. Matter of fact, last week I went to check, and I'm going to be close to my 10th year anniversary, actually, yeah. Now I'm hoarse, but it's because of the weather, not because of cancer.
Cancer is something that really puts it in your face that, you know, God, when he said you're going to die someday, he wasn't kidding. So I think that a major part of treatment for cancer is overcoming this fear and helping people to live as best they can. And that's what tonight is celebrating. Those who have understood this and are doing it.